Hey guys, what's going on? Levi here, and as many of you already know, today is January 7th, my 18th birthday. And in honor of that, what I wanted to do is make a video listing three important life facts, in particular about people, that I guess you could say has taken me 18 years to realize. So maybe for some of you, this is just already common knowledge, and maybe for the others, it's not. I don't know, this is just my personal list of things that I thought were very important when it comes to life and people. So number three, never be too quick to judge somebody you know little about or don't know at all. And the reason I say that is because you don't know who that person is, you don't know where you could meet them again in life, and you don't know where you might need their help at some point in your life, maybe 5 years down the future. And another reason I say don't be too quick to judge somebody or jump to conclusions on somebody or act ill towards them is because you don't know who they know. They could be friends with one of your friends. They could know somebody in your family. You know, the point is you don't know when this person could appear back in your life and you just burned a serious bridge with them. And now you're like, oh, what do I do? He's in my life, and I thought he was out, and I dissed him, and now we have this awkward relationship. So the second thing that I would say that I have come to realize is people may talk a big game, people may say this or that, or I'm going to change this, or I'm going to fix that, but really what you want to do is you want to pay attention to people's actions. And the key reason that I say pay attention to actions is because people may say, you know, I'm going to go do this, or I'm going to go take over that, or I'm going to be the best at this. And while they may have the best intentions, actions are going to tell you if any of what they said was true. So it's not, you know, necessarily the best and most effective way to learn people through words. It's through actions. You're going to learn everything you need to know by watching that person over a time period do something, whether it's nothing or something. Actions are going to tell you what and who a person is. And I'll give you a real good example of what actions are, what I mean by that. A few years ago, I guess I was in 10th grade, one of my friends, real good guy, he came up to me, and he doesn't ask me for money, he doesn't, you know, he's not like a beggar or anything like that, but he said, hey, I'm short on money today for lunch, can you loan me $2? And I said, yeah, you know, what the hell, I'll loan you $2, you know, I'm not expecting to be repaid or like a give and receive type of thing. So I loaned him the $2, and he was like, man, I'll pay you back. And I was like, man, you don't even have to worry about it. And I just completely forgot about it. I went on the day. I wouldn't even, you know, it was $2. It was nothing to me. But I remember the very next morning when I got into school, that morning, he found me out of the clear blue and, you know, went right out of his way. He said, hey, man, I got your money. He whipped out his wallet. He pulled the $2 out, and he gave it back. And I was thinking, wow. He actually remembered, like he actually took his time to remember that. He was honest. And that can tell you who a person is. That action told me he's an honest guy. I can trust him, even though I wasn't expecting him to ever do that. Even though I wasn't expecting a return on the money, he did it anyway. And that is action. And lastly, the number one thing that I would have to say that I've learned in 18 years is, this is key, be careful of who you surround yourself with. And I'll get into more detail. You know, I think there's a saying that says, if you hang around with snakes, sometimes you get bit. Well, that's kind of where I'm going at with this. What I'm not saying is go avoid everyone because they have, you know, different ideas or different, you know, ways of life than you. That's not what I'm saying at all. So if you are a person with certain morals and values and you're with a completely different group who doesn't believe in any of that, then there's going to be a huge disconnect between you and whoever else. But let me give you an example on this. Let's say you're at the mall and you've never committed a crime in your life, but you're with four people who all have backgrounds in, you know, robbery and thieving, and you know, you walk in a store and one of them gets busted for stealing. Now, you may have not done anything wrong. You may have just been there to shop and look around. But all of you are going down that night. You know, anyone who's there is going down. Because you were involved, you're now part of it. You're now part of whatever they did. You know, let's say you're with somebody, you're with a group of people, and one of them gets busted with an ounce of cocaine. You know, I don't think I need to elaborate too much. So, yeah, just find people with common interests, common ground, things you both like, and you know, good people, good life, bad people, fill in the blank. But Take that information, do whatever you want with it. It's your life, it's your call. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave it a thumbs up. If you want to leave your life tip in the comment box below, feel free to do so. And I'll catch you next time. Also, make sure to watch Around the Block.